Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's Kujo Hamza here. Just thinking, contemplating some stuff, man, lately, you know? I believe in one thing, each one teach one, each one reach one, right? And I'm just here thinking about how long it took us to be able to get where we're at. Meaning, most Muay Thai instructors that bust their ass, had to lay their bricks, how to prove their points, how to get to where they're at, how to push themselves into the industry with credentials, legitimate credentials. Not this, go to Thailand, take a couple of pictures with certain camps and come back and all of a sudden got about 20, 15, 30 fights and all of a sudden now I'm an instructor and own my own gym because I opened up an LLC or a subchapter S and all of a sudden I claim myself to be an instructor. With no credentials, with no real education and teaching, and on top of that you misguiding the people, because the people are, my people are lost mostly over lack of knowledge. You understand what I'm saying? Besides knowledge of self. Why do I say all this? Because lately all these promoters nowadays are just taking any camp and putting them on the show to fill in just to be able to sell some tickets and put their guys in there. Back in the days, man, even Lou Neglia wouldn't allow you to put yourself out there if they never knew any of your credentials, any of your lineage, any of your history, or if you even were a legitimate instructor, even if it was kickboxing or karate. You had to have some credentials in your background. You had to come from an authentic person. I don't get it nowadays, you know what I'm saying? Back in the days, you just couldn't come up on the block and hustle. That's the way I looked at it. Nowadays, I'm looking at everybody and all of a sudden, everybody's just coming out of nowhere, take a couple of pictures, have one or two fights in Thailand, these local little stadiums or a bar in Pattaya, and all of a sudden, they come back and they say they're instructors. This shit is freaking crazy, man, what I'm seeing nowadays. And I know yous, OGs like myself, that has been teaching since back in the 80s, can see the difference. Now, don't get me wrong, I love the sport, it's growing. And most guys nowadays come from someone. Come from someone. If it doesn't come from me or Aziz, it doesn't come from Phil itself or Vladimir Borden or Master K or a lot of these guys, Crew Willie or themselves or Tommy Tai and all these guys that were back in the days out here. A lot of them all came from one of us. No matter how they like it, what they want to say, whatever it is, they were with us before they came out of nowhere and opened up their own shit. If they're legitimate from out here. We lay bricks to get where we're at. You know, our product speaks for itself. Our fighters go out there and put in work. In a matter of 2 or 3 years, my guys are putting in freaking work. I got guys been with me for 10, 15 years and they're killing it. Dudes already coming out there and doing what they gotta do. What I mean by that is that all these dudes nowadays, they're opening up these camps and they're making all this money and doing what they got to do because their school look fancy or they got a little backing or they got some financial gain from someone else. I'm proud of them. I ain't hating. I don't hate on nobody for speaking the truth. I just speak the truth. Who are you? Who is you? Who ever heard of you? I don't get it. So you can call me what you want to call me. I don't taste no blood in my mouth, so I want to keep speaking my shit. You heard? So the way I look at it is real simple. To be in all actuality is like this, man. A lot of the OGs out here should be respected. Stop acting like when you come see us, like you don't know who we are. My nigga, you know who we are. Pay homage. You heard? That's all I got to say about this. Hopefully, y'all can feel me on this. You heard? Because this shit is getting a little bit too out of hand with all these guys that don't know what they're doing, opening up schools, misguiding people, hurting people, getting people hurt, beating up on their own students, sparring with them, hurting them, putting them in shows they don't deserve to fight in. All of a sudden, they train a little something, come out of nowhere, put all these Buddhas around their neck and all this other extra stuff and start acting like they know something. I don't get it, man. I don't get what these guys are doing nowadays. They're going to get these guys hurt. And it's going to be their fault that you're damaging the people, man. Instead of killing your people, give them life, man. Give them light. Stop playing with all these other people's hard work and thinking you're giving them these false confidence, thinking they can step up to the scene with trained instructors, with trained instructors at the corner, with trained eyes at the corner going against their fighter. Our eyes alone change the game. Because of the years that we have experience, we know what you guys are doing. Can you fight on your back foot? Can you move to the left? Can you move to the right? Can you move forward? Can you even shake right? What happens when you can't figure it out? You're going to get hurt. And your corner, what they're going to do? Oh, you're doing good. Keep pushing forward. They're not even understanding what the guy's doing to them. Look, man, when we pick our Pokemon, we pick them because we chose them. And that's what they are. When we choose our Pokemon, we expect them to do what we're telling them to do, not what they feel like doing. Don't try to be a G and let your student do what he wants every time he's in the class. And then when you bring him to the corner, think he's going to respect you. If you don't know how to put that authority down from the giddy up, you ain't going to get that authority when he's out there fighting. With that being said, I pray you guys can feel what I'm saying. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Sawadee kap.